We all want a dope-looking Linux desktop setup, and Hyprland is the way to go forward these days. However, setting up Hyprland itself is the first and biggest hurdle you will face. ArchRiot is one of the new Arch-based distros that offers a pre-configured Hyprland out of the box. I tried it recently, and I'm going to share my first impressions of this opinionated Linux distro. Opinionated distro based on Arch Linux with Hyprland. Wait. Have you not heard that before? Yeah, that's right. Ruby on Rails creator DHH announced his opinionated Arch with Hyprland in the form of Arch Linux a couple of months back. ArchRiot started as a fork of the same Arch Linux, but it has evolved into a distinct Linux distribution since then. Apart from different looks and default tools, ArchRiot now also has a few homegrown tools that improve your experience. We shall see them in this video. When you log in, you will be greeted with a minimal but functional desktop. ArchRiot uses Waybar at the top with an app menu on the left, a central clock that expands into a full calendar on hover, and system monitor widgets on the right. The app menu is neatly organized into sections and includes a search bar for quick access. The default terminal is ghosty, which feels lightweight and modern. I tried ArchRiot in a virtual machine, so please note that the lack of GPU caused poor desktop animations at point. I think it would have performed better on a bare metal system. ArchRiot includes a handy control panel, press super plus C and you can tweak key system settings graphically. This makes quick adjustments much more convenient. Remember, Hyprland is keyboard centric. Need a refresher on shortcuts? Press super plus H to bring up a help screen with all the keyboard shortcuts neatly arranged in sections. It's a small touch, but it really lowers the learning curve for new users. You can cycle through ArchRiot's curated wallpapers using super plus control plus space keyboard shortcuts. The help menu also lists a theme changing shortcut, super plus shift plus control plus space, although in my testing it didn't appear to change anything. ArchRiot comes with some interesting defaults. For example, it has Jet Editor, which is lightweight, but on systems without GPU acceleration like my GNOME Boxes test setup, you'll see a warning. Next, it has web app integrations for Twitter and Google Messages. They are launchable via the app menu. Privacy-focused apps like Signal Messenger and Proton Mail are also available out of the box. Well, defaults are sensible. XFCs, Thunar as the file manager, Brave as the browser, and Ghosty as the terminal. It's lean, but it's not bare bones. For resource monitoring, ArchRiot uses BTOP, which you can launch with Super Plus T. For updates, there is a custom upgrade system utility that checks for updates, applies them, and cleans orphan packages all in one go. ArchRiot also ships with Migrate, a text-based backup utility. It's straightforward, and in my test, I backed up my home directory to an external drive in just a few steps. Currently, it only supports backing up the home directory to external storage, but still it's a nice inclusion. As you can see, ArchRiot is a solid choice for people who want a pretty looking Hyprland and Arch combination without going into the manual effort of configuring it on their own. Yes, Hyprland setup takes a lot of time and effort even for something as basic as changing wallpaper or taking screenshots. Anyone who has ever tried Hyprland on their own will appreciate a pre-configured Hyprland setup that distros like ArchRiot provide. I like the fact that developer is putting effort into tools to make things easier and smoother instead of just focusing on the looks. Kudos for that. What do you think? Can ArchRiot be the next on your distro hopping list? Share your views in the comments, please. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye for now.